tester.co.uk.
Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this review on test leads. Now, this may sound really odd to kind of do a whole review on test leads, but again, as you may know, if you've been in electronics for a while, you will no doubt have loads of test leads for either powering devices, doing measurements, or connecting pieces of circuits. And having the right test leads and the right connectors and adapters can make life a lot easier. Things can also go awry if you don't have the kind of right wiring in your test leads or the right connectors. Things can slip off, you can disturb a measurement, you can disturb a circuit from working. Depending on the types of metals that and the connectors, you can have issues when you're connecting to batteries with things corroding. So there's a fair bit more to the kind of humble old test lead than perhaps meets the eye. Now, what I'm going to do in this review is show you a whole set of my own test leads. Some I've purchased, some I've made myself, the pitfalls and perhaps the benefits of making test leads yourself, and then perhaps buying a set of functional test leads. Now, here I have to give a big thank you to Frankie again. The good man, when he sent me the LCR meter for review, he popped in a whole set of test leads that he sells on his eBay store. And again, you can either get hold of Frankie through my forum, I'll put a link below, or through his eBay store. And I must say, for the price, as you'll realize once we get down onto the bench, for a reasonably good set of leads, they're not bad, because you can pay a lot of money for a set of silicone fluke leads or a name brand set of leads.
Right, well, where on earth to start? I will just start off by kind of showing you roughly on the desk space that I have here. These are all the bits and pieces that Frankie sent to me, and it is by no means his complete set of leads, but we'll be going through these. But before we get stuck into these and the functionality that they do have, I'll just show you, give you a quick shot of the leads that I have hanging up. Right, so I'll just show you what I have got here on little cup hooks next to the desk where I work. And again, ideally when I go and set up my lab in the States, I plan to kind of make it a bit more ergonomic in terms of getting to my leads, but perhaps most of you might have a similar situation. And for the most, all of these leads, for the most part, besides the little crocodile clip connecting clips over here, are mostly homemade. So where I've had a need to put something together, then I've got a piece of wire and I've put some connectors on the end, whether they banana plugs or crocodile clips, to make up a lead that I've needed. Now, that can always be quite handy, but one can often be sacrifice kind of the quality of the connectors that you might be able to get locally at your electronic shop, or even by the type of wire. So that's kind of some of the bits and pieces that I'll go through as we look at these leads. But let's have a look at the bench and what I've got there. Right, so let's start off with something which perhaps most people have then if you're working on light electronics, and those are these very lightweight Croc clips, the kind of interconnecting clips that you'd use if you're working on a little circuit. Now, obviously, because of the thinness of the wire, you're not going to be passing a high current through these, so that's certainly one thing to note. But of course, if you're working on a circuit, you don't want anything with a thick diameter, because this is obviously going to be very fiddly to work with if you've got a little breadboard and you're trying to connect things. You're going to want something nice and easy, which is easy to maneuver. But there are obviously kind of Croc clips and Croc clips, and sometimes it's difficult to kind of test these if you're ordering online or if you get going to your electronic shop and you can't open the bag. But there's perhaps a few things to be wary of. Some of the things I found on these is the kind of rubber or the insulating boot here sometimes can be very slippery and you can't actually grip the actual opening mechanism. So that might be just something to note if you are able to grip them and feel that they're open. Then probably the next biggest thing to look at, and this, I don't know whether you do get any good quality Croc clips in this range, but if you hold the jaw open and slip the boot off and then have a look at how they're actually connected to the Croc clip themselves. And these, as you can see, they aren't soldered, they're crimped. There is, if you can note there's a little bit of loose wire dangling about. So you might want to look, and you may come across a set which are put together better. To tell you the truth, I've not seen any high quality versions of these, because I think they just generally are slapped together. But if you do have the chance, that's what something you might want to do. Right, so then the next thing I want to show you is a purchase that I again made at my local electronics shop, thinking that these were quite versatile. They're a set of test leads, and they came basically, if you can note, you can screw on various connectors or Croc clips, so it makes them fairly versatile. So they've got these banana connectors, but here again, note it's the kind of, it is the splayed out type, and these very easily either become loose and you have to splay them out, as I often do with a screwdriver. And the wire on this, even though it looks relatively thick, when I used to use these on my power supply, and as soon as I went above about 1.5 amps, these would start to get very warm. So obviously there's not a lot of copper inside. So again, something to be very wary about. There's no rating on the wire itself, and things can soon go awry. If you have a circuit under test and it happens to be running at 2 amps and you've got low quality wire, then you could be in for a problem, and obviously potentially serious problem if you have the wire melt, it could start a fire. So that's the one very thing to be wary about. Buying cheap is sometimes not a good idea. If you are going to buy cheap, then only use your cheap cabling, your cheap test leads on low current circuits, so that you don't run into that risk with high current and melting wires. So just another thing to note about these cheapies that I had, you can obviously, it came with like all test probes as well, and you screw them in, but after a while the connector here would sometimes rip out, and you could see only strands of wire connecting to them. So certainly not a lot of copper inside them. And then also I used to use these to connect onto a car battery to just read the voltage, and I was monitoring voltage, let's say on a multimeter. And I don't know if you can see it, I'll bring these in as close as I can, but you can see how these have corroded, and these aren't the worst. I've had to throw away several sets of these. So it's something to be aware of, that obviously when you're on connecting to battery terminals and you've got different metal types, they can react with each other. And if you don't have a reasonably good quality Croc clip or a fair bit of metal there, you can get this happening, corroding, and obviously things can go awry there. So just something else to be wary of. Right, so next let's just move on to a few of my kind of homemade leads that I've put together and some of the things to be wary of. You know, sometimes you're kind of forced to do a quickie and a nasty to get some leads together, and they can be functioning and fulfill a role. Here I've gone and used what in essence is probably speaker wire. There's a reasonable amount of copper there, but obviously they're not rated for high current, so one has to be wary about that. In this instance, you can see the actual banana plug again has a splayed out connector, and these are gold plated. Now it might be one consideration if you want a really good connection. I am going to show you a set of Croc clips which are solid copper, and we'll talk about that, but certainly gold plating does mean you get a good contact, and they should be fairly low resistance. But these banana plugs are the type which are screwed on. So I'll just show you that. You can see they've got a screw. They've obviously got the hole so you can jump in with another banana clip if you want to piggyback on them. But they are screwed in, and inevitably, over time, either that screw comes loose or it doesn't bite the wire nicely, and that becomes a problem. They come loose and it can just be a right pain. So I then move to, I've got these leads over here. These ones have also got a screw in them, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove the cap so you can see that, because these are another type to be very wary of. So as you can see, it doesn't have the screw which is obvious to the eye. A couple of things I want to note here again, it's a better connector than perhaps the cheapest splayed out one that I showed earlier. I'll just bring it up. You can see again these splayed out ones which press together and eventually come loose. This one has got a kind of hard piece of wire on the side here, but the ones with a nice splayed out end are typically better. Here I want to note again, I'm using perhaps some electrical wire, but it's stiff and can be a bit of a pain if you're in a confined space trying to connect things up, because it tangles and it gets in the way. So those again are something to note, but let me just slip the boot off just to show you these. Right, so I've gone and pulled one out of a parts bin, and this one, as you can see, does have the kind of splayed out connector on the end there, but as you'll see, it has these little small screws which you're supposed to then secure your wire in there. And there's a couple of things there. These little small screws obviously pop out very easily. If you do have a wire with any reasonable diameter copper or wiring inside and you put it in there, it can then be a real bugbear to try and get that screw in there and to fit. And I certainly don't recommend them. So that can be a real pain from that point of view. What I've resorted to doing out of frustration with those is actually soldering them. So I'll show you another set of homemade test leads, and I made these ones are nice and short because I was testing batteries and I wanted very low resistance and a short run so that the voltage drop was minimal. I got silicone wire, which is kind of SABS rated, which is South African Bureau of Standards. So it's good wire, so I've started slowly moving up the path, but I still had some of these old screw type banana plugs, and I resorted to soldering them and then having to kind of heat shrink them to get them together, and not the best. You can see the heat shrink here is just kind of slipping off, and here I soldered on these banana plugs, actually then soldered them inside. So I would certainly recommend moving to something more like this, which is what I finally ended up doing, is buying a good set of banana plugs. These happen to be gold plated and they splayed apart, and they are designed so that you actually solder the wire into the actual plug itself. So you get a good proper connection which isn't readily going to come undone. And then as you can see here, so you can see this is 2.5 millimeters squared and it's got a rating on there. It says SABS, so it's obviously a fairly good piece of cable and rated up to 100 degrees Celsius. It's silicone, but because of the size, it's not that supple and flexible. It's still fairly stiff. It's all right for certain applications, but sometimes again on the bench when you're trying to connect things up, it can kind of get in the way. Right, so then we come to the test leads that I received from Frankie. Now I've got an honest admission to make here, which hopefully Frankie won't bat me over the head when he hears it. Frankie sent these to me packaged with the Mastek LCR meter, and the package arrived and I opened it, and inside was obviously the Mastek meter and these test leads. And I was actually more excited about seeing these test leads than the meter initially. But it's just because it is such a pleasure when you do have a good set of test leads to work with, which have got the flexibility of multiple tips and the way they can be connected. So a couple of things I want to highlight. These again have got the splayed connectors at the end. They're not gold plated, but again you've got to understand whether that's really important for your application. These have got a little bit of strain relief at the ends. I'm fairly sure that if you go and look at a comparable name brand or Fluke, they're going to have a nice flexible end. But the wire itself is, again, it's a nice supple silicone. It's rated on there. I think it's got 13 AWG and 200 degrees Celsius. So there we go. You can see that on the lead. And these are nice and supple. And I can tell you now, for the money, and you'll need to go and check with Frankie and on his actual store, I don't think you can go wrong. The handy thing is he's got different lengths, so these are not too long, which is great, because it can sometimes be a bind on the bench having a set of leads which is too long and gets in the way. So these are nice length, and I say they're nice and supple. What Frankie included in the package was like these connectors, so you can actually go and hook two sets of leads together. If you need to have make a longer set of leads, so you've got that functionality as well. Right, so the next set of leads which Frankie included was this set. Now again, so that the connectors on the ends of these have got shrouded banana plugs with the insulation on them, and they've got the 90-degree bend. So these potentially are quite handy for plugging into a multimeter and then test connecting your various tips, whatever you want to use. They're longer, so again, it's handy. You've got a choice of either having shorter leads or longer leads. These also, for my one power supply, so something to note. These are very handy for connecting up and powering something, and in that case, then these are probably the best for most power supplies, the ones with the unshrouded plug point at the end here. Whereas these are perhaps better for multimeters, but my one power supply does actually accept these. They plug in, so it's a nice solution for my one power supply. Right, so the next set, again, same nice supple silicone leads, have got these shrouded banana plugs at the end, but they're built so they're stackable. So you can then interconnect other banana plugs in here if you wanted to take a measurement, or there's multiple reasons why you might want to actually stack your connectors together. So you've got that functionality. Right, and the socket inside is a nice solid receiving socket for the actual banana plug itself. So certainly a nice firm solid fit, and as you can see, it obviously accepts a shrouded plug going in there or a normal banana plug. So let's go through some of the kind of bits and pieces that Frankie did include in the pack. The kind of most obvious functional piece is the detachable or add-on crocodile clip. It's rated there, it says maximum of 10 amps, so it does certainly at least have something noted on there that you need to be aware about. And they obviously fit nice and firmly onto the banana plug itself. Reasonably good feeling insulation boot as well, because often these can be very cheap and tacky, and these certainly don't feel bad at all. And a nice solid firm crocodile clip. Next, I want to note Frankie also sells solid copper crocodile clips. Again, a nice boot, and obviously built to connect on a banana plug. Now, these are quite handy because solid copper will give you a lower resistance. So certainly if you're looking for a really low resistance connection, then the solid copper are certainly something to consider. Next are these lighter crocodile clips. Got a very nice feel to them, nice spring resistance, and they obviously have got a nice little jaw to connect onto little wires or bite onto something to take a measurement, and obviously they've got the insulation right over the actual jaws themselves, and these obviously mate very nicely up to these leads. They just plug in, nice solid fit like that, and very functional. Right, and Frankie also included some probes, and as you can see, they've got the same functionality. They can either kind of slip onto the banana plug like that, but ultimately these will be designed to fit on the shrouded type. They really mate nicely together, so nice shrouding, nice protection over here. And if you're wondering why this cap is on here, I'll just pull it off, and I can tell you now, the tip on these is razor sharp. It really is sharp. That would pierce something. Oh, yes, it is needle sharp. It would enter your skin very easily. So hence why to certainly retain those little caps, because they could certainly cause injury if you don't keep these. But certainly if you're testing fine electronics and want to get somewhere very small, you've got a lovely sharp tip on these to do some testing. Right, next, another set of test probes, again, with a nice connection onto the shrouded banana plug. These have got a cap on there, which is obviously functional. I'll just show you the top. It's the tip has got a very sharp spike down there, which you can obviously put on top of a wire or a track or something to actually test to keep the rest of the tip protected. So as you can see, this is also functionally can be plugged into a banana socket, receiving socket, but also a very nice sharp tip on the top as well. Yet another test probe with the same connector type, and again shielded. You'll note it's got a little cover, insulation cover on the tip, and again for a good reason. really, really thin, a very fine tip to these, and razor sharp. So if you're trying to get into small places to take measurements, I presume, I've never really used anything like this, but I can imagine on a small circuit board or perhaps trying to probe the legs of an IC, this may be one way to do it, but a very nice fine tip for getting in places with a very sharp point. Right, and again, another very handy addition to the set that Frankie sent were these little grippers, and I've been making a lot of use of these. These have got quite a robust hook on them, which is obviously nicely shielded. It's nicely protected when it's sprung back. It's got, again, the shielded banana receiver, so you can connect it to those the other test leads. And these are really handy for connecting to wires if you want to grip a wire like that to hold it to either pass electricity or a current into it, or you're trying to take a holding on there to take a measurement. And in particular, if you're thinking of like testing components like diodes and capacitors and you just want to grip the leads in this, this is a perfect solution for that. Now, one thing to note, I've got something similar which I bought from RS Components. Also kind of this gripper style, but it's got a very different gripping mechanism. I'll just demonstrate. If you can see there, you can see those little fine little wires coming out and splaying apart and then coming back in. Now, that is obviously very different from what comes out, the very solid strong hook of the grippers that Frankie sent me. And I have often tried to use these to kind of grip wires or to grip the leads of capacitors, and that's not strictly the correct use. And in fact, that kind of use with these delicate grippers in these will potentially damage these over time. These have certainly a particular use, which I'll demonstrate now. Right, so here we go. I've got a little test circuit that I'm actually working on at the moment, and in there I've got a 555 timer. But if one was wanting to either kind of supply, let's say, a voltage to an IC or take a reading, then these are just perfect for getting in there. They're not going to short against the other pins, and they grip really nicely and are very, very fast. South African term for being they hold very well to grip that, so you can either take a measurement or, as I say, feed it with some current. So a very definite use for these. So just be wary of that if you use this kind of gripper incorrectly, you will potentially, they'll lose their grip and not be that functional. Whereas obviously Frankie's, the more robust, probably which has got more functional use, is certainly not the type of thing you're going to be using on an IC, because it will obviously touch the leg next to it and it's just too big. Right, so last but not least, Frankie did include this little bag inside the package as well. And if I open it up, so you can see, he's included some silicone wire of varying gauges. So he's got a thinner gauge here, one that's slightly thicker, and then the thicker one. So he really has a really great selection if you do then want to go ahead and make up your own set of test leads, if you feel that you've got a specific need which perhaps a pre-made up lead doesn't help. He then obviously sells these separate bits and pieces which you can go and connect up and make your own test leads. So a lot of functionality in the kind of pre-made up ones, and then you can go versatile and make up your own test leads with some really nice supple silicone wire that he sells. Right, so I hope that little review of test leads might give you some indication and some ideas if you are kind of stepping into setting up your own bench or looking for some better test leads at a reasonable price. I'm still new to this game, so I'm still kind of learning and finding out what's best and what works and what doesn't, but I can tell you now, when Frankie sent these to me and I started playing with them and using them, I realized how functional and how well put together they were. It's very easy to recommend Frankie because he's very responsive and he genuinely wants to make sure that he's selling a good product. So again, Frankie, thank you very much. Look at the links below, because I'll post links to how you can contact Frankie. Again, thank you very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.
Tester.co.uk